Wakey, wakey. Hey, buddy. You're out for quite a while. You can thank me for saving you sometime later. But for now, time to get up.
Okay, this is wild. I genuinely don't even know where to start. Blackmagic just dropped DaVinci Resolve 20, and it's a game changer. Not just a few tweaks. I'm talking over 100 features that feel like they were built by filmmakers for filmmakers. There's no way I can cover them all in one video, but here are my top 15 favorites. So if you use Resolve, or you've been thinking about switching, you're gonna wanna see this. Let's dive straight in. All right, first up, and this one's a big one for editors. Resolve 20 now has a completely redesigned keyframe panel. Before, animating felt clunky. You had to dig through menus and switch tabs, functional, but far from smooth. Resolve 20 finally gives us a proper, dedicated space for animating inside the edit and cut pages. You get grouped tracks for things like transform, cropping, Resolve FX, all expandable, organized, and way easier to manage than before. Plus, there's now a full curve editor built in, so you can control easing and transitions visually without jumping around. But here's the thing. They also removed the retime curve under clips, which was actually super useful for quick speed ramps. Personally, I hope Blackmagic brings that back in future updates. This new panel is great, but I'd love to see both options coexist because that curve under the clip was fast and intuitive. Next, AI beat detection. This one's built for speed. I've been waiting for this for years. If you're editing music videos like me, this is gold. It's the kind of tool that makes you wonder how we ever worked without it. Resolve 20 now automatically analyzes your music and marks the beats directly on your timeline. No more scrubbing through audio or guessing the rhythm. You drop your track in and boom, instant beat markers. Whether you're syncing B-roll, cutting to a rhythm, or building a montage, it's plug and play. Editing to music just got 10 times faster. This one's crazy. AI Music Retime, or as it's officially called in Resolve, AI Music Editor. Resolve can now automatically stretch or shrink your music track to match the length of your edit, without changing pitch or quality. So let's say your video or social reel is 15 seconds, but the track you love is a full minute. No need to manually cut or fade. The AI retimes the music to hit your in and out points seamlessly. You can enter your desired time manually, or, the way I prefer, just trim the clip to match your video length, and it adapts automatically. This saves so much time, especially when you're trying to match energy, pacing, or hit specific beats in ads, trailers, or social content. And if the first version doesn't feel right, it gives you four variations to choose from. It feels like cheating, but in the best possible way. IntelliScript brings AI transcription right into the timeline, and it's a major upgrade. It automatically transcribes your dialogue and lets you edit your video by editing the text. Cut a sentence from the transcript. It cuts the clip. Move text around. The video reorders itself. It turns interviews, vlogs, and long-form content into a faster, smarter editing experience. Built natively into Resolve, no extra software or round-tripping needed. Text just got a serious usability upgrade in Resolve 20. You can now create proper text boxes with automatic wrapping. That means when you type, the text flows inside the box naturally. No more line breaks, no more fiddling with alignment. It works exactly how you'd expect in a modern design tool. Perfect for titles, subtitles, or any kind of layout with paragraphs or blocks of text. It's a small change, but one that saves time every time you use it. Magic Mask just leveled up. Version 2 is faster, smarter, and shockingly accurate. It uses a new AI model that can track people, clothing, and objects with insane precision, even in tough shots. Now, instead of drawing strokes to define a subject, you just add a few quick points, like dots, and Resolve locks on instantly. You can isolate a subject, create targeted color grades or do advanced composites without rotoscoping. It's real-time, GPU accelerated, and works on longer clips with better tracking stability. For colorists and VFX artists, this is a massive quality of life upgrade. My favorite feature of the cut page was always source tape. For quick edits, it's unbeatable, especially when paired with the speed editor. I don't usually work in the cut page, but that one feature alone is fantastic. And now, the best news, source tape is finally in the edit page. You get a scrollable reel of all your bin clips laid out as one continuous timeline. Skimming footage, setting in and out points, building a rough cut, it's all faster, smoother, and right where most of us actually edit. Huge win for speed and workflow. This one fixes something that's bugged me for years. Subtitles are finally animatable. In Resolve 20, you can now keyframe subtitle position, size, and tracking, just like regular text. That means smoother transitions, motion synced to speech, or even creative effects, without having to convert everything to text layers. It keeps the subtitle format, but gives you real motion control. Super useful for stylized captions, music videos, or anything short form where subtitles are part of the design. Finally, a proper vertical video workspace. Resolve 20 brings a new layout specifically for vertical timelines. The viewer and timeline reorient automatically, so you're not wasting half your screen with dead space. Everything feels cleaner and more purpose-built when you're working in 9x16. If you're editing reels, shorts, or TikToks, this just makes the whole experience feel right. Here's a big one for anyone who builds titles inside Resolve. You can now create multi-layered text, all in one text box. Let's say you want a headline with a shadow, a background, maybe a second line with a different style. Before, that meant stacking multiple text nodes or jumping into Fusion. Now it's all in one place, fully editable, layer by layer. It's cleaner, easier to manage, and makes complex title setups way less of a headache. As you've probably guessed, I'm not a camera guy, and I don't record my voice that often. But for those who do, here's a cool new feature. In Resolve, you can now record voiceovers directly from the edit page. Click the mic icon on the timeline, a pop-up lets you choose your input, and you're ready to go. There's even a countdown, so you've got a second to breathe before it rolls. If you do narration, tutorials, or just need to punch in a line, this makes the process quick and frictionless. Color grading just got more intuitive with the new Chroma Warp tool. This feature allows you to adjust color hues directly in the viewer using simple strokes. By dragging across colors, you can shift hues in a single, fluid motion. For more precise control, the point-to-point mode lets you isolate specific regions for targeted adjustments. This approach makes complex color corrections feel more natural and efficient. Superscale has been around for a while, but in Resolve 20, it gets a full AI upgrade. The new version uses a neural engine to upscale your footage with way more detail and clarity, especially if you're going from HD to 4K. It preserves texture, sharpens edges, and avoids that overly plastic look older upscalers sometimes gave. I tested it on a few old clips, and the difference is instantly noticeable. This one's all about speed. Quick export presets in Resolve. You can now create your own export presets with custom settings and access them right from the quick export menu. No need to dive into the deliver page every single time. I've already set one up for my YouTube videos, including this one, and it's made my final step way faster. Just hit quick export, choose the preset, and it's done. It's a small tweak, but it removes a lot of daily friction. Last one, and it's not even out yet, but I'm already excited for it. Blackmagic teased a new AI set extender tool that's coming soon. The idea is simple. Take your shot, and the AI extends the background beyond the frame. If it works anything like what Adobe and Runway have been doing, but natively inside Resolve, it could be a game changer for creative flexibility. Can't wait to test this once it drops. Those were 15 standout features from DaVinci Resolve 20, but honestly, this is just the tip of the iceberg. There are tons of other upgrades packed into this version, from AI tools to subtle workflow tweaks, way more than I could cover in one video. That said, keep in mind, this is still a public beta. If you're going to try it out, back up your projects first, or wait for a more stable release before switching over for client work. And if you're looking to level up your shooting game too, check out my latest video on 6 gimbal moves and hacks. It's already up and packed with tips you can use today. Hit that like button if this breakdown helped, and I'll see you in the next one.